And as you could probably already see from the title of this video, I would be kind of like presenting myself as the finalist for Miss Earth. Now, what is even Miss Earth, you're probably wondering. Just to give you like a presentation of the Miss Earth organization, it's basically an international environmentally themed beauty pageant. It's promoting environmental awareness with like different activities like school tours, street campaigns, coastal cleanups, eco fashion shows, environmental fairs, and many more. Now, it's also one of the big four international beauty pageants. The other three are Miss World, Miss Universe, and Miss International. Now, Miss Earth Foundation also works with environmental departments like Greenpeace and World Wildlife Organization. Now, you're probably wondering, why did I decide to compete in like the Miss Earth and not in like any other, you know, beauty pageant? Well, since I was little, I was always really, really passionate about healthy living, healthy lifestyle, healthy food, you know, just sports. I was always this sporty girl who loved running, loved dancing, loved doing everything. And I was also really, really environmentally conscious, as I am still. So when I saw that this competition exists, I was like, yes, I really want to compete in this. This really spoke to me, so that's why I decided to go and compete. I'm now a finalist for Miss Earth 2018 in Slovenia. Throughout the whole year, we had like different challenges and events that will all merge together at the final night, also called the coronation night, that will take place on the 15th of September in Ljubljana. If you want to, you know, come and see the event, maybe support me, I will leave all of the info about when and where will the coronation night be in the description box down below. Now, I'm kind of decided to present my vision and how I decided to participate in these challenges throughout this whole video. We had six challenges and now I'm going to kind of like describe them to you and how I participate in them. Now, thank you for watching this video. I hope you're going to enjoy it and thank you for watching. Bye. Okay guys, so we're here in the kitchen where the first challenge took place. Now, as you can probably guess, we had to showcase our cooking skills, which means it was a cooking challenge. Now, everything took place in Koper, in this excellent restaurant called Savor. We had like 15 minutes to prepare a vegetarian dish with the given ingredients. Now, I decided to create tomato cream pasta. I kind of wanted to create something that was classical but still has like this splash of extraness in it, which I think I created with the cream added to the like tomato sauce, right? And yeah, at the end of the challenge, judges decided that my dish was the best, which I was really, really happy about and really surprised. The whole thing was really, really a great experience, so that's it for this one. Next challenge! So the second challenge was a talk show. This time the route led us to Begunje in Gorenska. We stayed in a beautiful hotel, Lamberg Mansion. So the first thing that was planned for us when we got there was two classes. The first one was a style class by our fashion designer Miriam de Bernard, and the second one was a public speaking class by Jasmina Spaholic. It all kind of looked like a round table. The judges gave us environmental questions and themes and we answered. The debate, I gotta say, started to flow quite quickly. I have to say the whole thing was a really amazing experience and by no means easy. So yeah, next challenge.
Hi guys! So the third challenge. This one was a talent show. It all went down in Rabana Resort in Kranjska Gora. We stayed there for 2 days. The first day we had a talent show and the second day we had a fashion show, but I'm gonna talk about that in the next challenge. In the talent show, I decided to perform a dancing act. I kind of freestyled to Beyoncé on like the three different genres. That was hip-hop, cheerleading and pom-pom. Since I trained cheerleading for 9 years, so I decided to showcase my knowledge in that area. I would say the judges were amazing and it all went down really, really nice. So yeah, an amazing experience. Next off, fashion show. Bye!
Hi guys, so we're here in my room where I created this dress. Now you probably already know that I'm going to talk about our fourth challenge, which was the fashion show. Now we had to create an eco-recycled dress. It all took place in Ramada Resort in Kranjska Gora. Now what I created here, a dress entirely made out of recycled PVC bags. I collected them from grocery stores and basically anywhere that I can find it. The dress is 100% plastic, which means I didn't use any other materials, I didn't even sew, I just knit it. I took inspiration out of my favorite fashion house, which is Dior. It took me 3 whole weeks to create it, and you're probably wondering why I decided to use, you know, plastic bags. Now, if you don't know yet, plastic pollution is one of the biggest environmental issues today. It's full of toxic chemicals and it's really dangerous for our sea life, the entire ecosystem, and also our groundwater. The list can continue on, so that's why I decided to give this recycled plastic another chance to shine. Yeah, so this is it for this challenge. Let's go to the next one. Bye! Hi guys, so fifth challenge was the eco project presentation. It all went down in Kopar in this excellent restaurant that I mentioned before called Savor. Now for this project I wanted to kind of like share my knowledge and spread awareness for a topic very, very new to my heart, and that is veganism and its effects on the environment. I've been vegan for 5 years now, so that's why I wanted to share my knowledge and my thoughts with the judges. I think the whole project went really well. I was really enjoying when I was presenting it, and at the end I also served them my signature dishes, two dishes. One is like a sweet dessert. I prepared a vegan vanilla cake and like a spinach pie. The judges really liked it, so I was happy also. So yeah, that's it for this challenge. Let's go on the next one. Bye! Hi guys, so we're here in nature and this is the sixth and the last challenge. It was the fitness day. The day for us started in Coffee Point Šiška, where we had our morning breakfast and coffee. Then we headed out for hiking to Rožnik Hill. Throughout the whole hike, fitness coach Jan Tampa gave us some tips and tricks and showed us how to correctly execute some like exercises. It was all really fun, and when we came on the top of the hill we had this amazing lunch in Gostilna Rožnik. After that there was a quiz waiting for us, and yeah, that was the whole day. I really, really enjoyed it. Since I was always a sports lover, this was like the day for me. And yeah, that's it. Thank you for like bearing with me the whole six challenges, and thank you for watching. Bye!